Alec Monopoly here. I was doing graffiti of the Monopoly man in the streets, and I was tagging Alec next to it. So people just kind of associated Alec with Monopoly man, and then it was just kind of given to me naturally. Well, the mask is from graffiti culture. I mean, painting in the streets is not allowed, so to have the ability and freedom to continue painting in the streets, you need to remain anonymous. The theme of money started out with, you know, the game Monopoly, the goal is to have the most money. And it goes hand in hand with Monopoly, and it's a symbol of affluence and, you know, just fun. I love painting dollar bills. Yeah, I started in New York and then I moved to Los Angeles. I was getting in a lot of trouble in New York for graffiti. There's a lot more authorities against graffiti in the streets in New York. LA is a little more liberal, there's more wall space, it's a bigger city, and some beautiful California sun. I have been arrested for graffiti. It just comes with the territory. Nowadays, I've shifted to more positive connotation, and I'm painting in places where I'm given permission. I still do some graffiti here and there that, you know, isn't per se allowed, but most of the time I'm putting my energy into positive situations. And as a graffiti artist, the goal is for people to see your graffiti tag everywhere. You know, you want to choose the busiest spots for people to see your pieces. So I look at working with a company like Tag Heuer as like another way to express my graffiti, you know, whether it be on the watches that people are wearing, you know, advertisements I'm designing for them, stuff like that. So this is the connected watch, and it has one of my paintings that I painted on canvas, and then we kind of digitalized it, made it smaller. I painted 300 of the watch bands, hand-painted, so each one is unique and each band is different. So basically, when you buy this watch, you have an original piece of Alec artwork. Tomorrow, we're doing an amazing graffiti installation. Art is for the artist himself to express himself, and you know, for me, it's a form of therapy. It's releasing my ideas, my expressions, and then also it's for the people. You know, it's all about inspiring people, giving them happiness. Yesterday, a little 8-year-old girl came over and she was so excited to meet me, she started crying, and I felt bad she was crying, so I gave her a spray can, I was giving her a little lesson, and it's like, I think that's the beauty of art, is inspiring others and you know, allowing them to create as well.